So, Alan, as a previous recruiter and hiring manager, I'm sure you have seen thousands of resumes and hired thousands of people. So, in your expertise over 30 years, what are some of the key things that a hiring manager is looking in a resume? And we know that as career coaches, we tell job seekers, customize your resume word by word for each job so that they can pass applicant tracking system. So what are your top three things that job seekers can do to pass ATS?
ATS is overrated and misunderstood.
Okay.
So what I was a hiring manager. There's hiring managers and recruiters. Hiring managers are the decision maker. Recruiters are the gatekeepers.
Screening.
But in either case, what gets a viewer's attention quickly, logos of companies, schools that you attended, titles that you held, a trajectory that you've had in your career in terms of getting promotion. Bullets that have quantifiable impact.
Yes.
Location matters for roles. Years of experience matter. Everything else that you massage and you try to put keywords in, you're just putting lipstick on a pig. So recruiters and hiring managers are really looking for those key elements.
And we know that recruiters maybe have 6 seconds to scan a resume to see if it's a yes or a no. What about the first part, the accomplishment or summary of accomplishment? Is that like emphasized a lot, or there should be bulletin points or key things there, or what's your take in that part?
So there's if someone has a clear background, a clear experience, I would not put a summary or an objective up there. If you're a clear salesperson, account executive, and you've done that all in your career, you don't need a summary section. If you've gone around multiple places, like me, I've worked in operations, sales, marketing, global companies, tech, finance. There, it might be helpful to summarize for the person a quick recap of what you're bringing to the table and ideally quantify the years of experience. I know a lot of people tend to shy away from that because of ageism, but that actually works to your advantage more often than not. And also, if you've managed teams, how large of teams you've managed. So, that information to put in a summary is good data points to catch someone's mind. If you don't need the summary section, don't use it because again, recruiters are looking for companies, titles, progression, years of experience, location, and that you don't, whatever you summarize, anybody can write words down.
Yes. And in our previous conversation, you talked about the cover letter. So there's also this debate. Shall I put a cover? Shall I not put a cover? Some people say that if hiring manager, sometimes they first read cover letter and then they read a resume. Sometimes they make a decision if there's a cover letter, they read and then they go. I know that it's very subjective. It all depends on the company, the hiring manager, but what's your take? What you have seen?
Attractive companies, cover letters don't mean anything.
Okay.
Attractive companies get lots of applications. Attractive companies are inundated with applications, so they're going to look at your application really quickly. They're not going to spend longer time to read your cover letter. As you say, people are spending about 6 seconds to evaluate a resume. How long do you think they're actually going to look at the cover letter with words and something to read? They're
Yeah.
not going to look at that.
Yeah.
If you're looking at a smaller company or a less attractive company or a company that or a job where writing skills is important, in that case, cover letters could be helpful. But in
Yes.
most cases, most of the like FAANG jobs, jobs in tech, jobs at top companies, cover letters are not worth their time.
Those are great tips, Alan. Thank you very much. Again, for the audience watching or listening, if you have any other tips, you can leave them below. So tune in next time for another great question with Alan.